What's the first thing that comes to mind when you hear social media?
Competition for attention.
Instagram.
Selfie.
People complaining.
Instagram, Twitter, Facebook.
Twitter, Instagram, Facebook.
Twitter and Facebook and things like that.
Connectivity with friends.
Advertisement.
Misuse.
Talking with my friends online.
Pinterest. Twitter.
Cyberbullying. I hate social media.
What even is social media? Social media. Websites and applications that enable users to create and share content or to participate in social networking. Here are the predecessors of the Big Three. In 1997, AOL created the world's first instant messaging system, allowing people to send real-time chat messages, emoticons, and play simple games. In 1999, LiveJournal became the first social blogging site that included features such as the user profile, friend function, and share function. MySpace was created in 2003 with a determination to surpass Friendster. The site practically stole all the cool features of Friendster, but introduced new features such as instant messaging, commenting on other people's posts, embedding YouTube videos, and embedding music. In 2003, LinkedIn became the first social networking site for business, which allowed people to create profiles, share their work experience, and connect with people in their industry. In 2004, Facebook hits Harvard. Facebook took the ideas of MySpace and Friendster, but made it ad-free and cool to use. By the end of 2005, Facebook expanded to over 2,000 universities and over 25,000 high schools. By late 2006, the website was a total smash hit and completely opened up to the public with just an email. Twitter was launched in 2006 to spread the word about concerts and their locations through microblogging. This is why there's a max limit of 140 characters. In 2010, Instagram was launched as a photo-sharing blog site with filters that were later known to combat Facebook. However, in 2012, Facebook purchased Instagram for $1 billion in cash and began to take its capital regime. Both of these social media sites have taken the world's attention. That is until this iconic ghost decided to make an appearance. In 2011, Snapchat creates the first IM software that allows people to send pictures of themselves that disappear after 10 seconds. When the story feature was added to Snapchat in 2013, the app tremendously took off. In August of 2016, the jealous Facebook Corporation decided to mimic this function and introduce Instagram Stories. In March of 2017, Facebook introduced Facebook Stories, and they continue to mimic Snapchat on both platforms till this day. So what's the big deal? According to a study by the Cyberbullying Research Center, cyberbullying victimization rates have increased from 18.8% in May of 2007 to a static 28.7% in November of 2009. Suicide is the third leading cause of death among young people in America, resulting in about 4,400 deaths per year. Over 14% of high school students consider suicide, and almost 7% have attempted. According to Yale University, bully victims are 2 to 9 times more likely to consider suicide than non-bully victims. All these statistics are very tragic in their own way. However, these answers have brought up a serious question that needs to be considered. Are students at Royal Oak High School safe from online harassment?
Austin? What's your...
What was the worst incident that you've been involved with, or do you think, have you heard of, that's like been really like surrounded with the phone?
One of the instances that's not bullying that never ceases to amaze me is that kids share inappropriate pictures on their phones and on social media. And I mean, we say it a million times. Please, I mean, it can be Snapchat and someone's going to screenshot it and save it and send it around, and it happens all the time. It is astounding to me what people aren't thinking about when they take a picture on their phones and share it in multiple platforms. I think people need to be really wise about that and
careful of what they see online.
How about not to do it at all? Like, just be careful. Assume that any text or any photo that you have is not a snapshot in time.
A good friend of mine has agreed to be interviewed about her past experience with cyberbullying. Here is her story.
I was first really cyberbullied in sixth grade because I just moved schools. And actually, she like got really mad that I had switched schools, and she started sending me like emails through like Gmail and was just like, you know, nobody really liked you anyway here. We all kind of hated you. We're all actually really happy that you're gone and like all this stuff.
When I was interviewing Mary, she confessed that she wasn't able to tell anyone about her story until sophomore year. Young people just don't recognize how dangerous their words can be when given enough power. Words with the strength to decimate human life at just the click of a button. Just because you can't see the other person's reaction does not make it acceptable to bully someone online. Thank you.
those 10 demonstrations. It's hardly sink or swim when all is well if the ticket sells.